Hey Dream Chasers, it's JC, and today I'm going to answer some frequently asked questions about how to design Twitch emotes. By the way, if you don't know what an emote is, it's just a custom emoji that you can use on twitch.tv. It's available to any streamer who is at least an affiliate, and you can set it up so that your subscribers on Twitch get to use your custom emotes. This is sort of a follow-up video to my how to design emotes video, where I covered stuff like size and expressions and making the best use of the space and things like that. Thank you so much to everyone who gave me feedback on that video. I'm so happy that I was able to help a lot of you, but some of you still had questions about emotes, so I'm gonna do my best to answer all of those in this video. Starting with, will you draw my emote? First of all, thank you. I'm very flattered that you like my work. I do sometimes take emote commissions, but I have a lot of other projects and things going on, so usually my commissions are closed. Sometimes you'll catch me when they're open. If you check Twitter or Discord or my Twitch page, usually I'll have a little mention of whether or not commissions are open at the time. You can always reach out to me, and if I have time and I'm taking them right now, I'll get back to you. But if my commissions are closed and you're looking for an artist right now to design your emotes, I'm gonna point you over to Fiverr. Fiverr just launched a Twitch store where you can hire emote artists, people to do your overlays and panels, and it's really cool because you can find all of those artists in one place. This video is not officially sponsored by Fiverr, but full disclosure, that is an affiliate link and I do get something if you sign up. I just want to be very clear and upfront about that. My next most common question is, the smallest size, 28 by 28, is blurry, what do I do? I totally feel your pain. When you resize your emote and you shrink it down to that size, it looks terrible and you're not doing anything wrong. There's really nothing you can do about it. 28 by 28 pixels is not a lot of pixels. There's not a lot of room to really have a lot of detail in that. So if you look at your emote at the smallest size and it looks awful, that's just normal. I do try to, when I shrink them down and look at them that size, to try to see, like, does it still read? Can you kind of get a sense of an expression? But really, it's not gonna look like much, and that's okay. That's pretty normal. As long as the 56 by 56 and the 112 by 112 look good, then you're good. The other question I get a lot is, what kind of emotes should I make? And that is a really hard question to answer because it really depends on your Twitch channel. The first emote that I designed for my Twitch channel was No Chill. No one has chill on my Twitch channel. We're all just really extra and over the top, and it just kind of became a thing. And so when I got affiliate, it just kind of made sense. My friend Kale McDonald has a little, like, hey, finger guns emote because, I don't know, it's his main character from his comic and it's just a really funny emote. My friend Eld has his little character just making this, like, wow, happy expression because it's kind of an inside joke. So I would say start with something that has a lot of personality from your channel and your chat. But if you don't have anything like that, don't worry. You can always come up with something else later. To start with, I always love heart emotes. I think heart emotes are really cute. They're really just sweet. I know a lot of people who collect heart emotes and they subscribe to as many channels as they can with hearts because it's just happy to, like, spam chat with a bunch of hearts. And there's all kinds of ways you can do that. You can make an object that's kind of in the shape of a heart. You can make a little chibi you holding a heart. And whatever you do, it's just really nice to express love. Hype emotes are a really good choice too because it's really fun to get just hype going in chat. My No Chill emote kind of doubles as a hype emote. It is so windy outside. Oh my god, I'm sorry for all this extra noise. Also, like, if you're just, like, a really friendly, positive person, a little hi emote that's, like, you waving is really nice. Lurk emotes are kind of cool because they're useful. A lot of people lurk, and it's nice to have a streamer you're subscribed to who has a lurk emote that you can throw up in everybody's chat. And if you're a gamer, you might like stuff like, you know, like a GG, good game, or RIP if, you know, you're dying a lot. I would suggest looking at channels that you like and emotes that you like and ones that you use frequently or see used frequently and think about what's the emotion that it's trying to convey. I wouldn't copy anybody else's design, but think about, okay, this is a really exciting emote, or this one's kind of throwing shade, or, you know, whatever it is, and make something that is your take on that concept or expression. A lot of the other questions I get are kind of technical, like what program do you use? What brushes do you use? So I personally use Photoshop to draw all of my emotes. you don't have to use Photoshop. You can use Clip Studio, you can use Krita, you can use any art program that you have. And I just use a standard round brush for everything because it's really just solid line work. There's not a lot of texture to my emotes, so I wouldn't sweat getting fancy with things like that. Another question I had, which I thought was interesting, is should you start on a transparent background? So personally, I never actually start on a transparent background. I'll start on a white background, create a new layer on top of it so I'm not working on that background, because you want to remove it at the end so you can have that transparency. And I will just kind of draw on that. And then what I'll do a lot of the time is throw in like a neon color that isn't used in my emote behind it to see if it shows through anywhere, just to make sure that I didn't leave any white space. And then I'll also throw in a darker background layer so I can see how it looks on a dark background versus a light background. And then when you go to export the file, you want it to have that transparent background. So you just hide all of those layers and then you save it as a PNG and you're good. I was also asked, are there any colors that you should avoid in your emotes? And that's kind of tricky because you can have emotes on a light background or a dark background. So you really have to think about how it's gonna look on both. I try to avoid colors that are very close to white or very close to black, so that they show up better on both kinds of backgrounds. I don't think there's really colors to avoid as much as values to avoid, so you don't wanna go too light or too dark. That said, I think a lot of really clashing colors in an emote can be kind of a lot to look at, especially when it's very small and they get kind of muddy. So if you're really unfamiliar with color, I would say avoid contrasting colors. Like, don't put like purple next to yellow unless you're confident that you can make that work. And the last thing I see people struggle with a lot is glasses in an emote. I personally don't put glasses on most of my emotes, even though I wear glasses and it's supposed to be me, just because it's really hard to get an expression down and put glasses on top of it. So my general rule for glasses, if you're gonna include glasses, don't include pupils and eyes underneath them. Just draw the glasses with like white space, or just leave the glasses off. Occasionally, I think it works to kind of do both, to put the glasses over the eyes, but you have to make sure that the glasses are big enough that you leave room to really see the eyes, and you just kind of have to be careful and test it out. I always draw glasses on a new layer and kind of hide it and play around and see if I like it. They work really well on emotes that don't have a lot of detail and aren't really busy and complicated, or don't have a really strange, kind of exaggerated eye expression. Like something where the eyes are shining and shaped like stars, putting glasses on top of that would make it confusing. That said, instead of doing the shining eyes, you could just put glasses and make them glowing and really bright and kind of get a similar effect. So glasses are one of those things that are just really tricky. It's a lot of trial and error. Generally speaking, I would say if you're gonna use glasses, make them very big so they read easily and avoid a lot of detail in the eyes themselves. A lot of people also ask me, where can I test emotes? I was testing them on Discord, but I actually found a better tool for that. There is a website that's the contrast tool. You can upload your emotes and it will show them on light and dark backgrounds and at different sizes. It's a really useful tool. I highly recommend it. And that's really it for my frequently asked questions. If you have any questions that I missed, please let me know in the comments and I'd be happy to answer them. Anyway, that's it for me. Thank you so much for watching this video, and thank you to everyone who left feedback and comments on my last video. I really appreciate that. Until next time, chase your dreams. This video is brought to you in part by my wonderful patrons whose names you're seeing right now. If you'd like to see your name in the credits or get access to behind the scenes content, bloopers, some art, you can get coloring pages. I'm gonna do comics at some point. Just go check it out at patreon.com/jcchase. Also enjoy this clip of Riley as a puppy. Oh.